All right, how y'all doing? This is Hawkeye, Snakes Behind the Camera. We're gonna do a box unboxing of my new Furious 200. Snakes got one too, but we're just gonna do an unboxing of one of them. Now, we bought this from HSD Go. HSDjets.com or
HSD
Go site. Now, we also thought about the EFX Racer from Hobby King, but it's actually smaller than this. This has got a 50-inch wingspan. Not to mention the fact that Hobby King wants $174 and some change for theirs, plus shipping. And you can get this at HSD Go for $129 with free shipping, plug and play. So, we're going to find out what's in the box. It's a 60-amp speed controller on it. Now, they say in the video, we watched the video, and Pete from Banana Hobby flew this thing, and he says anywhere from a 2200 3S to a 3300, or a 2200 4S to a 33. He does say the 22, either way, seems to be a little light, and the 33s seem to be a tad heavy. So I'm actually going to run this on a 2800 4S. He said that seems to give it the best CG and balance, so we're going to see. It's got a 2820 1500 kV motor. We're also going to do a build video, because this thing, you can have it built in about 10 minutes, maybe, because the motor's already in, the prop's already on, and there's four screws in the whole plane. So
that's pretty much it.
I know you might be thinking, holy crap, four screws. But yeah, that's it. Four screws in the whole plane, and that's it. So right. And to prove a point, because Snake's already put his together, I'm going to show you the instructions on this plane. There's the instructions.
Three pictures.
Okay, it's nicely boxed. Nothing's damaged. You've got the elevator.
Damn it.
One side. Here's the other side. As you can see, they're going to go through, and they're actually going to go in there, and it's going to snap tight together. The bar here goes into this side. That's what gives them both the controls. Here's the wings. Now the wing, you don't have to worry about servo wires, because they actually plug in to the fuselage. So there's no servo wires.
Nothing to worry about.
Servos are already installed, hooked up. I don't know if you can see it, but the little piece that goes through your horn here isn't plastic. No. It's actually metal. So, you know, how many times you've put them things through and tried to snap together and it was a little off and you bent it. You don't have to worry about it. And these things are very, very rigid, these wings. Very rigid. Which is good, because if you can see, anticipated racer, 140 miles an hour out of the box. Now, we've seen a number of videos. I think I might have to throw the BS flag on 140.
Yeah.
But they're damn quick.
Yeah.
They're very quick. I don't know about 140, but they're really quick. But there's the other wing, same thing, plug in. Everything's hooked up. I want to say the only servo that's not hooked up is going to be your elevator servo, because your elevator's not on yet. Here's your wing spar. Pretty thick. Here's your propeller, or spare propeller, shall I say. Actually, we've got these are 5x7s?
7x5.
7x5. 7x5 propellers, but we also have some master air screws, 7x5s.
Yep.
But, you know, they're a lot thinner, so I don't know. We'll see what happens.
They're just a better prop, I think.
But these things ought to be a lot of fun. If we don't put them in the ground.
Don't plan on doing that.
Or scout, shall I say, if I don't put it in the ground.
Don't plan on doing that.
Oh, I never plan on it. Don't stop that crap from happening, though. And here's the fuselage. There's a plug-in for your ailerons. Of course, it says free like wind in the clouds without a trace. So
yeah, we gotta fix that.
It's really nice. It's sturdy, really really well made bird. I've had a few HSD products, and all of them really, really seem to be nice. The canopy, got a latch, no magnets. There's your speed controller, battery strap. You got a piece of material down here to keep your battery from sliding. You really don't need no Velcro. Here's all your wires, your battery hookup, and should have plenty of room. My receiver will go right here, out of the way. All these wires, once I plug them in, of course I'll shove down here out of the way, so they won't be in the way of my servos.
Where I put mine, I push that up.
Yeah,
and put my servo,
slide them all back here in the back. Of course, there's only four channels, so it's going to be really simple. Here's the build part of it. The elevator, we're going to stick through like so. This side goes on like so. Of course, they plug in. Put a little drop.
Loctite?
Of Loctite. In the holes there. And put our screws in. No, it's not tight. I know that.
And I think this plane looks better than that one from Hobby King.
Oh yeah, I think it's a much better looking plane. And you're talking, you're probably talking about $70 cheaper.
Yep.
So it's a hell of a lot better looking plane at $70 cheaper. I'm sorry.
One more wing.
One more wing.
And the spar.
Of
are all this easy to build, huh?
Yeah, it'd be nice. Oh. Drop a Loctite.
How expertly you screw.
That's what she said.
It's like our first airplane build video, isn't it?
Yeah. Well,
I figured we'd pick an easy one.
Well, this one is so easy. Like I said, there's four screws.
And boom. And those are screwing into a brass fittings.
Yeah, it's not plastic. Got the screws, but they weren't wood screws. They didn't have a point. They were flat. They were machine screws. They screwed into a brass fitting in here, and they're really.
Oh yeah.
But this thing is very, very, very rigid. This wing is.
Well, that's a nice looking plane too. Come around here and give us a look.
That's what she looks like. Has the skids here on the wing tips and on the tail here. So if you put it on a hard surface, the belly really doesn't touch the ground.
Mm-mm.
The belly and the wings don't touch the ground. But he said this is it. I think it's a really nice looking bird. That's our HSD Furious 200. Like I said, HDS Go. HSD Go is where we got this from. $129 plug and play, free shipping. We made these, we'll let y'all know, and until then, y'all keep them in the air.